So after a bunch of emails, comments, messages, all that kind of stuff asking to do a van tour, I'm finally going to do one. I will show y'all exactly what my house looks like, where everything belongs in the van. That way you can get really a sense of what it's like for me to live in the van and where everything goes and how difficult or how easy it is to get things. So here we go. So about the van. It is a 2000 Ford Windstar, 3-liter V6 engine. Don't ask me what any of that means because I have no idea. I had to Google it. It has 187,000 miles on it. I got it when it had 175, I believe, or 172. So I put quite a few miles on it since I got it back in April. It runs like a charm. And a little fun fact, this is actually my mom's minivan. I had an SUV that I really wanted to convert, but it was too much of a hassle to take the back seats out. The back of the SUV wasn't flat, it was raised, and so it was not really great for building. This one, however, the seats come out of it really easily. It's a little bit longer than the SUV that I had, so back in April or back in May when I decided that I was going to do this, I was like, hey mom, I'm taking your car, and she's like, no you're not, and so we talked for a long time about it, and she finally agreed to switch cars with me, and so that's how I got the van. So thanks mom for that, you're the best. So pretty standard up here. Everything else, I try to keep the driving section and the front section very clean and organized. I have my shoes drying in the sun up there. For electricity, what I do, so what it is an inverter, and you just plug it into the cigarette lighter, which I keep over here, and then I just plug in my phone charger to it when I'm driving, or my laptop if I have to. It's just a really quick, easy way to charge my things when I'm driving. In the van, this is my only source of electricity in here. I don't have solar, I don't have a battery. So this is how I do all my charging in the van. Now for the living space. So my living space is the back of the van, basically, behind the driver's seat and the passenger seat. All of that encompasses my bed and my storage area, all that kind of stuff. So altogether, that gives me about 33-ish square feet of living space. It's tiny. It's not a massive van. It's just your regular soccer mom minivan. I can't even stand up all the way in it. To start off, what I've done when I took the seats out of here, I wanted some extra space. So I just took, this is advertising board, and I just Velcroed it to the holes that the seats came out of and put this cute rug over it. I normally use the passenger seat for like a little hanger, a little closet for my jacket. Down here is where I keep all my clothes. So this is the only compartment under this little part of the bed. I just got some heavy string and tied it to some carabiners to keep everything in place, and it works really well. So all the clothes that I own fits in this little container down here. The other part of under the bed has more storage under it. So I have just about 5 or 6 of these little containers under here. Just have miscellaneous stuff. Obviously you can see I'm a broke college kid, so there's some ramen noodles in there. Tape measure in case anything breaks and I need to fix anything. Stuff like that is under there. Some car care, all of that kind of stuff. So for the bed, I actually didn't have to purchase anything except this mattress topper right here. Everything that I used for the bed was in the shed in the garage that we had at my house. For the bed, because I'm so short, I'm only 5 feet tall, it was really easy for me to fit a full-length bed just about in the van and be beyond comfortable. So I actually custom built the bed to fit me. So what I did was I laid on the floor and I got a tape measure and I marked with chalk on either side of my body and kind of rolled around on either side to see how much space I needed to be comfortable. Based on that, I just drew the dimensions out on some plywood that we had. And then I made this bed out of it. So the height of it is about 9 inches off of the floor of the van. It's 73 inches long and it's 25 inches wide. So it's very small, definitely one person bed. I've had some friends ask me to camp and like have have a sleepover in the van, and I'm like, guys, I can't really fit more than one person in the van. But it was a really fun experience learning how to build. I built the bed all by myself, and I was really proud of that. So that was an accomplishment for me, first off, right off the bat with the van, is to just learn how to do simple carpentry to build something as simple as a nice little platform bed. All right, so the other storage component I have in the van is this little cubby. I did not build this. This was a manufactured little cubby. I got this one at Target, actually. It was on sale. It was like $35. But it holds everything else that I need that doesn't fit under the bed. So here in this little cubby is like socks and underwear. And then over here is basic toiletries, vitamins, toothbrush, lotion, all that kind of stuff. Over here is more of like a miscellaneous cubby. It has laundry detergent. Here is this cute little part of the library. I haven't got to all these books yet. Here is like my medicine cabinet, basically. These little strings with the carabiners were such an easy solution to keeping things from flying off the shelves. So it's just a string tied between two carabiners, and the carabiners are secured on with eye hooks that are just drilled into this cubby thing. And so you just take the carabiner off when you need to pull the cubby out. I normally just hook it on over here, and then you can pull out your drawer, and then same thing to put it back together, just like that. And so that keeps things from flying off of the shelf. Over here, this is just another miscellaneous. This has baby wipes for when I need a shower and can't get to a shower, toilet paper, paper towels, all that kind of stuff. Over here is cooking supplies, just pots and pans, and spoons, bowls, everything down there. And then in this bottom one is some food storage, olive oil, oatmeal, vitamins, all that kind of stuff. That was a very easy solution, and it fits perfectly in here to have extra storage space. In the back, this is what the van looks like all put together. So to keep warm at night, I just do this double sleeping bag situation right here, tuck one inside the other. And then back here I have some extra storage, obviously the essential Oreos, this is granola, got some rice down there, rice cakes, granola bars, propane to cook on, my ever-present stack of books that I need to read for homework. So I keep my backpack back here, and then laundry. And then when we move back here, so this is actually perfect width between the wall of the van and the bed to hold my camp stove and my table. So this camp stove, what I like to do is actually just take it out and put it on the ground outside and cook on it. If it's really cold, I can actually put it in that little space over there and cook in the van. And then that little table just kind of goes outside when I want to eat outside. Over in this little corner, I keep my spare tire. There's tire iron behind there and a couple of jackets, and there's blankets under here. I keep my pajamas right there. So in the evening when I drive and I have the heater going, and the heat actually comes out from right there. So I always have nice warm PJs to put on every single night. So I use these little cardboard things to cover the windows, and I have some for that window and that one right here and this back window. And I just normally tuck them under here during the day so they're out of the way. But it's just cardboard, and on the other side of them is black felt that is tacked onto it. And it just keeps the light out in the mornings, and it keeps it a little bit like warmer in here, I suppose. It's not the best for sound or heat insulation. I didn't have enough money to buy like the nice insulation, so this was kind of my second option. And this is my little sticker wall. I don't really have too many up here right now, but I would like to. So if anybody who's watching this really has their favorite stickers or make stickers or whatever, feel free to send them to me. I will put it on here, and I'll display it on Instagram and Twitter and all that kind of stuff. For my address, just email me. My email's in the description. So I know that was really brief, but there's not really too much to the van, so that's about all I have for you. If you have any more questions about where I keep things, feel free to drop a question in the comment below. And just let me know how y'all think about the van. If y'all have any suggestions on if I should move things or maybe would be more effective somewhere else, that would be much appreciated, because I really am still trying to figure this whole thing out on what works best and what needs to go where and all that kind of stuff. So I'm always open to suggestions. I'm so grateful for the opportunity and so grateful for all the people who are subscribed to me, and I appreciate y'all so much. Thank you so much for all the love and support that you've given me. Okay, I'm gonna leave it at that. Like I said, if you have any questions or suggestions or comments, leave a comment down below and I will be more than glad to answer it. Also, if you want to send me emails, or like I said, if you want to send me a sticker, I would love that. So please email me and I will let you know how to send that to me. I just want to say thank you again for everybody who's watching and all my subscribers. I look forward to see how this semester plays out. I'm so grateful that I am able to get the word out about alternative living to college students, hopefully, and to high school students who are thinking about going to college but don't know how they're gonna afford it. I want this to be a message. So if you could just please like and subscribe and share this video, you know, like leave it up on a public computer, send it to your girlfriend, send it to your mom, send it to your grandparents, put it on Facebook, guys, whatever it takes to get the word out there. I want this to be a movement. I want people to take their dreams and take their futures into their own hands and be able to say, I went to college and I lived in a van and I graduated 100% debt-free. That's all I could ask for, guys. So with that said, I will see you guys next time. Thanks for tuning in.